Hi, this is Melanie Fine of Chem in 10. Today's question is as follows. According to Bohr's model of the atom, when an electron absorbs energy, it A, moves to higher energy levels, B, moves faster around the nucleus, C, moves to lower energy levels, or D, emits light. So let's go back to Bohr's model of the atom. Bohr supposed that the nucleus was in the center of the atom and that electrons traveled in energy levels around the nucleus. When the electrons absorbed energy, they would move to higher energy levels. And when they gave off that energy, when they relaxed back to a lower energy state, they would give off a photon of light. He got this theory from the spectrum of the hydrogen atom, and he attributed all the transitions back down to lower energy levels as bands on the hydrogen atom spectrum. Of course, the smallest distances would be the least amount of energy, so that would be giving off red light, and the higher energy bands would be the turquoise, and then the blue, and then the violet. So electrons gain energy, move to higher energy level, lose energy, and give off that energy in the form of light, either visible or other forms of light. So Bohr's electron orbital model is that electrons orbit around the nucleus in specific energy levels. Since the distances between the orbits in an atom are not all the same, no two leaps in an atom will have the same energy. That's why how you have different colors, different bands on the spectrum. The closer the orbits are in energy, the lower the energy of the photon emitted. A lower energy photon has a longer wavelength. So the correct answer is, according to Bohr's model of the atom, when an electron absorbs energy, it moves to higher energy levels. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to join us at chemin10.com, where you get the chemistry question of the day delivered daily to your inbox. You get more chemistry videos and practice problems, get help from our online chemistry community, and membership is always free. I look forward to seeing you inside Chem in 10.